Hello, my name is Sean Conley, and I'm the State Soybean and Wheat Extension Specialist at the University of Wisconsin-Madison. Today we're in a wheat field, and we're going to go through and discuss some of the steps we need to make in assessing early season stand loss due to winter kill or late seeding or other types of injury symptoms we may have had. Why is this important? The last 2 years in Wisconsin, we've seen some significant winter kill, either due to icing effects, lack of snowfall, or snow cover, as well as just very cold temperatures. So the first thing we need to do is go in at green up and we start seeing green plants across the field and make that stand assessment. Normally what we do is we walk into a field and what we're looking to do is make sure we have a minimum of 12 to 15 plants per square foot. Now, I'm fortunate enough to be able to use my shoe for an example because it's exactly 12 inches long. We move into a field, we place our foot in between two rows, and we count the number of plants within an area. In those circumstances, we are well over that threshold of 12 plants to 15 plants per square foot. From that decision, then, we really need to make the tiller assessment and realize when we need to make that nitrogen application. In wheat, what we generally use is 70 stems per square foot is a minimum threshold to make that timing for N application. If we're out here at green up and we have more than 70 stems per square foot, we can delay our nitrogen applications up to jointing. Okay. Now, if we don't have that minimum number of stems per square foot, we need to get the nitrogen applications on as quickly as possible in short area so that we can ensure tiller formation, so we have enough heads per unit area to maximize our yield, even in an area where we had some winter kill. Now, to assess the number of stems per square foot, we come out into a wheat field, and we can begin to dig up a few plants. And here's an example of a wheat plant. We pull up, and we can assess, first of all, the number of the main stem, as well as the number of tillers. And if we look at this wheat plant right here, we identify the main stem, and then we identify two tillers. Now, how we tell the difference between a main stem and the tiller is the presence of this structure right here called the profil. This structure is only available on the tillers. So if we're out there and we're having a hard time identifying the difference between the main stem and the tillers, or specifically we're trying to figure out how many plants we have, look for this identifying characteristic, the profil, and that can tell us the difference. So in this circumstance, we have a main stem with two leaves and two tillers. So under the Zadix growth staging system, which is the system that I prefer, we have a 12-22, and that basically gives me a very descriptive information in terms of, if you're going to call me, how many plants we have and the growth staging we're at for any type of decisions. So once we made that decision, again, we can see right here we're well below that 70 stems per square foot threshold. We would make that early season decision to make a nitrogen application quickly, right off the bat, to ensure that we can maximize our productivity on that wheat acreage in the upcoming year.